गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ न्यूरल नेटवर्क। ओके, यू कैन सी, आई थिंक यू कैन सी, जस्ट वन मिनट। ओके, यू कैन, आई थिंक यू कैन सी दिस, लुक, this is the neural network model. Yesterday you have already seen this, but now we have to go for the details. Input to the, look, this is the architect, artificial neural network, and input and this network model network are represented by the mathematical symbol xn. Okay. What's the screen? Okay, this is the screen. Each of this input are multiplied by a connection weight, just like a W1, W2, and up to the Wn. Okay, and the sum equal to W1 X1 plus W2 X2. So, and in this way we can increase up to Wn Xn. And this is the network weightage model. Where is the screen? So you can see this model, and thus if the products are simply is summed and fed to the transfer function of A to generate a result, and then it provides the output. This is the terminology, and the difference is the biological terminology, and there is the artificial neural network terminology. So we have to just know this to distinguish between these two terms. First, just remember your biological neuron, and then you just have seen in your artificial neural network. You can see that neuron, which is the neuron, it is called the node. The neuron is the in biological terminology, and the in artificial neural network it is termed as the node. or unit or cell or the neuron. And now the another point is synapse is just like a connections edge and link in the artificial neural network. Okay, and the synaptic efficiency is the connected string, or you may say this is the weight. And now in this the artificial neural network, we have to study details. The artificial neural network, NN is ANN, are programs designed to solve any problem by trying to mimic the structure and the functions of our nerve system or the nervous system, whatever you may say. The neural networks are based on the simulated neurons, which are joined together in a variety of ways to form the network. And another point, the neural network resembles of the human brain in the following, in two ways. That another one is a neural network acquires knowledge through the learning. Okay, means it is a one type of programming. And another is a neural network knowledge is stored within the interconnected chain known as synaptic weight. This is the two fundamental things. So you have seen there is a two things. First one is weighted strain, and means it is a priority based programming, and another is just like a experience, like a acquire in knowledge. Means it was a experience like programming. Means I want to give you an example that you have the three interrupts are there. Okay, say one interrupt is mosquito biting, and second interrupt is your friends is calling, and third one is your temperature is rising. But another example is interruption. It is maybe you have seen a snake at front of your leg. Your friend is calling and temperature is rising. Another set of example of interruption is that your boss is calling, mosquito is biting, and your room temperature is gradually rising. So this is a set of interruption. So you have to prioritize it. But say I am giving you the example only of three. But sometimes if another thing is there, say there is a parking in your MCB point, it is not trained to you or trained to this neural. Then if this type of interruption is coming, then it will not operate, not able to operate it. So this is the training. Means whatever experience or whatever logic you have put it, it can handle only this type of things. But other things are not interacting by your neural network algorithm. Okay. So this is the two main conditions for your designing a neural network. Now you have seen some neural network model. This is a basic model for your example. So you can see that at the left hand side, the red color bubbles are input layer, are in this and then the two sets of bubbles, which is shaded with the black colors, it is called the hidden layer. And at the right hand side, the output layers, which is again designed with this red set. So there is a two visible layer is there. One is input layer and another is output layer. In between the layers which are designed, it is called hidden layer. Okay. Now you can see the at the lower part, you can see the controlling strategy of the neural network. It is a simplified form of one neural network logic, that is neural network including connections called weight between this neuron. Okay, and the input is coming into this just like the above picture, and when it is a production, means after coming from the bubbles, black bubbles or hidden layers, then it giving you the actual output. But this output may be differ or from your desired point. Say our temperature, we are doing controlling a temperature control. First, whenever we got the information, that is our desired temperature is 22 degree centigrade. Or you may put your AC that is at the 90 degree centigrade. But after a few seconds or few times, you think that this is too cool and we need to increase our temperature. Then we just put it up to the 22 degree centigrade. But our process already have set with this 90 degree centigrade. So this is the difference between actual output and desired output. Or you may say, this is the set point value, difference between the set point value and the process value. Look, just remember, whenever we have performed some control system strategy, the process value is different, but process value is changed due to the variation of the process, the disturbance of the process, but our set point was fixed. But in this case, our process value is fixed, or process value is not disturbed here, but we are changing our desired value or the set point value. Just remember your normal conventional control system, and now this is the neural network control system. So at that moment, there is a variation and of the desired value and the actual value, that is seen just like a delta. And delta is not a huge variation. Delta is a very small variation. Then and then, their feedback path will again inform to the previous node or previous hidden node. And then it will produce the actual output after the comparison. Okay. And this is the model of your neural network. Okay. Okay, now come to the point of neural network architecture. In this picture, you can see the neural network in which every node is connected. Look, there is only four bubbles are there. The left-hand side is coming the input module, and the each bubbles or the each nodes are connected to others. And it is the bidirectional connection. In previous cases, you have seen there is only unidirectional connection, but here you can see this is a bidirectional connection. The arrow is coming from both sides. And this is called the fully connected network, because if there is some control strategy which is showing some error, then it will again come into the loop so that it can remove the error. This is the advantage of this fully connected network. Now, what is the feature of this network? The neural network in which every node is connected to every other node. Okay, and these connections may be either are excitatory means positive weight, or inhibitory means negative weight, or irrelevant means almost zero. So this is the features of the fully connected network. Now in the next picture, you can see the layered network. Just like in the first example, there is some layer. But in this layer, you can put some conditions. Then it will be a conditional, it is a conditional layered network. The first left hand side, that is called layer zero, it is input layer. In between the two hidden layer, there is a layer one and a layer two. Look, in this layer one, the two bubbles are interconnected. Okay, and then layer two, also the three bubbles or the three nodes are there, which are interconnected among them. And then it is coming to the layer three, means layer output layer. From this input layer or the zero layer, if there is no bubbles are there in between the layer one, it is directly connected to the layer two. And this is the main feature. Look, in this layer, first layer is comprised of three bubbles. Then the layer one is again two bubbles. And again, the layer two is again comprised of three. Layer three is comprised of two bubbles. So three, say it is a J, and the next one is K. So J is greater than K. And if you put some J layer one, and the layer one is less than the layer two, again it is coming, layer two is greater than layer three. So this is the one by one, and greater than or less than, greater than or less than, and combination. So these are the network in which nodes are partitioned into the subset called the layers, with no connections from layer J to K if J greater than K. So if we just remove the node in physical node, input layer and the output layer, so there is no connection if J greater than K. So layer one is J and layer two is K. Okay, if J is greater than K, then there would not no connection. But here J means layer one is two and K is three, layer three. So here J is less than K, so it must have some connection. But if there J is three nodes and K is comprised of two nodes, then there should not be any connections. This is the condition. And now we are coming to the next architecture, that is acyclic network. Just like previous, but the conditions is different. And look, the acyclic network, in this, this is the subclass of the layered networks, in which there is no interlayer connection. Means there is interlayer means, say in previous picture you have seen in layer one there is two nodes, but two nodes are internally connected. But in this picture, you can see the no nodes in the same layer are connected internally. This is called acyclic network, and the conditions is there. In other words, a connection may exist between any node in the layer I and any node in the layer j for I less than j. Okay, but the connections is not allowed if I equal to j. So in this network, you have to make some differentiation between the number of nodes in each layer. Say in the input layer there is a 3 node, in the layer 1 there is a 2 node. If there is a 3 node, means I and j become 3 equal to 3. So there should not be no connection. But in this case, you can see 3, next layer is 2, again next layer is I plus 1 layer is 3, again I plus 1 layer, next layer is 2. So 3, 2, 3, 2, and in this way. So this is called the acyclic network. And now, in the next picture, you can see this is the feed forward network. This is also just like the previous one. And the conditions is there. This is a surplus of acyclic network, just like it came. Okay, in which a connection is allowed from a node in layer I only to the node in the layer I plus 1. So there is no back connection is there, only forward connection is there. So the acyclic network and the feed forward network, just like it came, it is a surplus, means another part. But conditions is that only the connection should be provided in I and I layer to the I plus 1 layer. But no back connection is there with I plus 2 I 1. Sorry, I plus 1 to I. This is the feed forward network. Only it can feed to the forward path, forward node only. Okay. Then we are coming to the modular neural network. In this picture, you can see there is a one input channel is there, maybe more than one input may be there, but it is at a module, only one by one, or it is coming there and then distributed. Okay, so if one module is input module is coming in, and then it is distributed to the next layer only two, you can see the one node is not totally connected to the all nodes, but the hidden layer one, it is connected only two nodes. Then again the input, next input, it is coming to the one node or the another two nodes. It is not connected with the other all nodes of this layer. Then from the layer one to the layer two, means sub hidden layer one to hidden layer two, the two node is connected next one node. But these two nodes are connected, not connected to the other node. Okay, look, there is a three nodes, one, two, three from the upper side, lower side. But the first one, node one is connected with the previous two. Then the second node of the layer two is connected with the previous two nodes. Then the third number node only connected with the previous node, previous two nodes. Okay, so it is a module type. Only two module are two nodes comprise a module. And this module is connected only within this portion. This is called the modular network. But where it is necessary, where the official hierarchy is required, then we have to put some modular neural network. So there is no interconnection, or the all are connected to the other separate nodes. And now you can see the many problems are based. Is solved using this new modular neural network. Okay. whose architecture consists of several modules with the pairs interconnection between them, and modules can be organized in several different ways, as the hierarchical organization and successive refinement organization on input modularity. Okay, so this is all about your architecture of neural network. Now another point is there, which is the learning mechanism. Basic of the learning idea is it is a program or the coding, but it is quite different from the coding. In your coding, you only put a set of program in which only conditions are applied, but you can't put any decision and to choose a set of program. Say you have three sets of program, set A, set B, and set C. Or you can say you have the three plans, plan A, plan B, plan C. Within your plan A, there is some feature condition or some switch case condition. Likewise, in your B and C also there is a condition. But whenever you put some program to your controller or computer, only one program you can assign. Means only within this if else conditions are there, but there has no decision making capability by which it can take which plan should execute. Say at that time you need plan A, after few minutes you need plan B, and after some time you need plan C. But when you need this plan to execute, to be executed, then it is no decision. But in the neural network, there is some mechanism in which it can take some decision so that it can choose the set of programs, say plan A, plan B, plan C. So this is called the learning mechanism of the neural network. You have to teach them, you have to learn your neural network. And this is the fundamental things of your neural network. And say when your a 1 year child is there, he or she couldn't know how to sleep, when sleep, and how to eat, when to eat, or anything. But whenever you teach them, after 1 or 2 years, it can learn when it need to eat, when it need to sleep, or when it need to play. And after 2 years, maybe it is 3 to 5 years later, the baby can also learn in which way or in which manner he or she needs to play, he or she needs to eat, or he or she needs to sleep. So this is the learning mechanism. So several conditions are applied, and it is gradually he can try to learn more things. Some mechanism is there in which it can learn itself automatically. This is called the decision making capability. Okay, so this is the difference between learning mechanism and the programming. Okay, normal coding. Okay guys, if you have any question, you may ask me. Okay, thank you. I stop here.